everybody, good morning. This is Jean here from True Love Quilts For You. Today you can see I'm in my kitchen and the pie making season is here. I've been busy making pies and I just wanted to share with you the pies that we're going to be making. I know, pot holders. You're going to get sick of me making pot holders. But look, aren't I cute? I'm making pies. Pot holders that look like pies. Real cute for the holidays, for your family dinners. You go in the shops and tons of pies. So that's how I was sort of inspired to make this pot holder. Add 10-inch squares or whatever fabric you have around and a bit of rickrack. I've given you a tutorial to make the whole pie. Real cute little things. So I just thought I'd be cute and bring it to you from my kitchen. So anyway, I hope you enjoy this tutorial on how to make these quilted, pocketed, pie-shaped, pie-themed pie holder pot holders. Okay? So I hope you enjoy. Thanks. Bye. The ingredients today to make our pie is you always need a bowl, right? Here's our pie. You can use, this is obviously to get the round shape. You can use anything, a lid, you can use a compass. You can make your pie however big or however small you want. But I just literally used a Pyrex bowl. I believe this is almost, I should have had this ready. It is 10 inches, oh, 9.5 inches. So you could use it, you can use 10 inch squares for this actually. And this is the point I wanted to make. I made this pie here, excuse me, with a blueberry or blackberry printed fabric. And it just reads a dark bluish purple, which brings me to the selection of fabric. There are many manufacturers on the web or whatever, or in your stores, that actually do fruit or vegetable or food printed themed fabric. This is one of them. E-Quilter, my go-to, Robert Kaufman, I know, Hobby Lobby and Nancy's Notions have a nice selection of these fabrics. Here's just a few of them, and I wanted to just address something. What I've actually done before I get to my ingredients, as it were, is I've actually pulled just a red tone-on-tone, which could look like a strawberry pie or a cherry pie. So you don't need the novelty fabrics at all. If you have a red square, 10-inch square, by all means, that you think looks like cherries, maybe a peach-colored fabric for a peach pie. I have these. I've pulled these from my stash. This is like a batik. Again, this is like a blueberry pie, bright blue batik, so you don't need the themed fabric. Here's another one, more of a deeper purple tone on tone. Now, here's two. Here's a raspberry, but they have green leaves. And am I bothered about that? I wouldn't, maybe I would be. But like, I don't know, we're not building the Eiffel Tower here, we're just making a stupid pie. So maybe like that wouldn't bother you. Here again, here are cherries, but they have the stems, right? But this is what I just wanted to show you. This is pure raspberries. And to me, aesthetically, you're going to spend an hour or so making your little pot holder. You want to do something nice. So I would go with something either an actual authentic fruit or a color way, all right? So that's just that. In fact, what I'm going to be doing is before I get to my ingredients, I'm going to be showing you how I actually, this is I think I had gotten a quarter of a yard of this. So what I do literally is I just take a Sharpie and I just go around the fabric or a pen, whatever, it's just for a cutting line. And I will be cutting out that circle. As you can see, I'll just cut that circle out, and I'll probably, for demonstration's sake, be showing you this fabric. But anyway, on to our ingredients. So we have our pie, and then what we need to have we need, and keep, there's a lot that goes into this. Like, it really does. This is a substantial little pot holder. I want you to realize that. And what I have actually done, doesn't it look professional? I think it does. I actually bought this, like, ironing board fabric. You don't need to. But I had seen it at, I believed it was Joann Fabrics, and I thought, oh, I like that. I think that looks really, really professional for the oven mitt here. And so I bought that. So I'm using, but you could actually just use a backing fabric because you have your Insulbrite. So again, quickly, we got our pie fabric. Then we need two pieces of interlining. This will not show. Again, this is just, I just used a white cotton muslin, cut in the circle. Then you're going to need, if you're going to be using the backing, whatever is going to show here, you need two pieces of backing circle fabric here. Again, I use the silver ironing board fabric, but you could use whatever you want to show on the back. Then what you need is you need one piece of regular batting, and then you need two pieces of the Insulbrite, the metallicized insulating batting. You need two of these. Now, what I have done, though, however, if you want to pay careful attention, is I've actually cut both the Insulbrite and the batting about half an inch smaller than my piece of fabric. Again, only so we don't have all of that tremendous bulk when we go to stitch it, because we have a lot of fabric here. We have the binding, we have the doubled rickrack. So what I, and actually it sort of makes it like pie shaped actually when you do that. So what I do is when I cut my batting and my Insulbrite, I'll cut it the exact size of my pie, of my bowl, and then what I do, as I've already cut it, I've already done this, I'll just fold it in half, it having been the exact size, and then I'll just cut off about half an inch, just around, and then I get that smaller piece there. Okay, so we have those fabric ingredients, and then, believe it or not, this takes quite a lot of bias binding. So, I have two packs. It takes about a pack and a little bit, but you do need more than if you're going to do this configuration. If you don't want to do as many lattices, you could just probably get away with one pack. But I like this lattice arrangement on the top, so I have two packs, and I have one pack of, this is jumbo rickrack. You could have regular rickrack if you want. I want jumbo rickrack. Now, I want you to see that this binding and the rickrack is cream. I did not use bright white. Having said that, it's a little bit difficult to come by cream rickrack. At least it was at my shop. You can get the cream bias binding. Bias tape, extra wide, double fold. This is by Wrights, and this is also jumbo rickrack by Wrights. So I got the cream. If you're going to go to the trouble of making this, I like the cream, but if you can only get white, I mean, it sounds redundant, but it might make a difference to you, is you can always dye it. You can always just stick it in, not a tea dye. I quite like coffee. So like the day before, if you have bright white, you could just make a cup of strong coffee and just unravel this and just stick it all in. Shush it around, and then the next day it'll be more of a darker cream, because I think pastry is not bright white. Anyway, that's a little tip, whatever. Whatever, you can use whiter if you want, but I just thought the cream looked a little bit more authentic. So these are our ingredients to make our pie. I'm going to be cutting out my raspberries to make our pie, and then I'll be showing you how we put it together. So I'm using my raspberries for my pie. I've cut out my circle, and what I want to do is I want to open up a pack of the bias binding and take it off the cardboard here. And you might, oh, aren't these wonderful? I love these cardboards. I collect them. What am I going to do with them? But they're such cool pieces of card. Why would you throw that away? Oh, can we say hoarder? Anyway, I have this, the bias binding comes off. You might want to press that. You just might want to iron those little creases out. It does make a little bit of a difference. So what we want to open that up. Now, I don't know if any of you knew this. Forgive me if you do, you most probably do. But when you take the bias binding off of the card, this bias tape, extra wide fold, there's an actual right and a wrong side. One side is bigger. Is wider than the other, and obviously, so when you go to stitch it onto something, what you do is you stitch it from the smaller side, and then it automatically will catch on the wider side. You get that? So you always, if you're going to nestle this anywhere, if this is the method you're going to use, you put your binding and you stitch it on the smaller side so that it automatically will catch on the larger side. So I'm sure you knew that. So we're going to press this. What we're going to take is we're going to take our Raspberry Pi and we're going to put that face down. Then we're going to take one piece of Insulbrite. And again, I've addressed this before. I swear there's a right and a wrong side. I put the shiny side down, centered on my pie. Then we're going to take one piece of the interlining fabric, which will not show. And we just place that down. Now, having ironed your pieces, what you can do is, I want to show you this. If you do your pie in this configuration here, what you want to do is you want to cut. I cut as I go along, and I make them a little bit strong, a little bit longer than my pie, just a quarter of an inch or so. What we're going to be doing is find the exact middle of your pie, however you want to do that. You can eyeball it, and you're just going to take it over to your sewing machine. Don't pull it real taut, but you're just going to stitch that down with the wide side down. Aesthetically, this isn't, you just want the wide side down because you just want those two lovely folds there. So you find the middle of your pie and you stitch on either side. And then literally what I do is I would cut this piece here. So I just make it a little bit bigger to work with more manageable pieces. Then I take my next piece and I measure and I cut it. And what I do is I do one that way. And then there's no real rhyme or reason. And then one this way. And then I'll come back and I'll do about an inch and a half away from the center. I'll come this side and I'll stitch this down nice and straight. And then I'll come on this side and I'll do this. And that way you get more of like a, I didn't actually do it too good here, but you get more of a woven fabric like lattice. Ugh, if you want to be bothered, you can just do all three, but you know, just right across or this way. But I quite like that, to take a little extra time to think, oh, that it just goes on top of each other. You're not weaving it at all, you're just stitching that down. But then your top stitching shows that, like, this one is underneath it and this one is over it. Do you understand what I'm saying? Sure you do. So you just want to go over to your sewing machine, and you're going to, if you want to, oh, somebody told me I need to pin stuff. Yeah, yeah, you're right, whoever that was. You might want to pin this so it doesn't shift on you. I don't pin it, but you might want to pin that, yes. I'm going to iron my pieces. I'm just going to iron my strip of binding, and then I'll just start cutting my pieces, and then I'm just going to go over, and I'm going to stitch it to make this lattice-topped pie. So I'll be back. So I'm here. I'm stitching my lattice to my pie, and this is what I meant. I've cut my piece to length here, and what I've done is I've started sewing in the middle, one across, one down, and I just keep going that way. Again, it's you don't have to be ridiculous about it. It just makes it more, a little bit more interesting, that one goes over, one goes under, and it looks a little bit woven. Again, remember there's two sides to it. You want the side that has both folds on it. You can just eyeball it and then stitch very, very closely to the edge of your tape all the way down. And you can feel it being quilted. You can feel the fabric being quilted. Actually, you could just sort of go back on yourself if you want, like that. Just flip it around, sort of like that, and then just come, just stitch it nice and close. You can go slower, and having secured it with pins, I was told people need to use pins, so I haven't. So there you go. So that's how I'm going to be stitching my lattice to my pies. And then when I'm done, I'm just gonna cut that off to make it a nice circle. All of these bits, I just find it a little bit easier. So it's a waste of a quarter of a half an inch. It's okay. And then I'll just go back and I'll just start putting my lattice on. I've stitched my lattice to my pie, my pie top, in this configuration. And actually, look how lovely that comes up, like quilted. It's a shame we won't see that, but that's okay. So what we want to do now is we want to just put that to the side. What we want to do is we want to take our other piece of inner lining, our other piece of lining fabric, and then we want to take one more piece of Insulbrite and lay that down, having centered it. Then we want to take another piece of our backing fabric, if you're using the silver fabric, or our backing fabric. And then what we're going to do is we're going to quilt this, but this is how it's going to end up. This is how it's going to show. That's going to be this. These layers are going to be this part of our pot holder. So actually, if you're going to be using it as a pot holder, look at this, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pieces of fabric. So it's a nice substantial pot holder. But what we want to do with this now here is we want to, I think if you followed my along with my other pot holder tutorial, what we're going to do is I'm going to quilt this, as it were, but we don't have to do it like this as such. I'm just going to literally go over to my sewing machine and start in the middle, and if you can see that, just make one in the middle, and then maybe one there, one there, one there, and one there. And that's it. We're just wanting to quilt the backing, this piece here, of our pot holder, and then we'll affix it to this here. So I'm just going to go over and I'm just going to quilt these lines of my pot holder. I've quilted this back piece here, as you can see. It's just been quilted with the three pieces put together, and it's going to end up on this part of our pie, the inside backing of our pie. But we can just put that aside for now. We're now going to make the handle, the pocket, as it were. Now what you want to do is with one, this is a little bit tricky, or not, what you want to do is you want to take your piece of backing here and then turn it around, and then your piece of batting, and this is, this is how I do it. I just sort of fold up to about, this one was a little bit small. I want to make this one a little bit bigger. On the circle, I want to just sort of fold up a little bit more than half. Do you get that? Here's the edge of our circle, and I just want to fold this up to about half along there, like that, okay? And then a little bit, like maybe 3/4, and then I'm going to just crease that really good, the batting and the backing, just crease that, okay? And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to come along, and I'm actually going to cut this batting. This piece here is just this pocket, and it's padded. It's not necessarily it doesn't have the Insulbrite. It's just padding for the back of your hand. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay that piece there, and I'm going to just turn that up like that, and I'm just going to go along. And I'm going to quilt that. exactly like I did here. This piece, it's got, your hand is going to go right in there. Do you see that? So I'm just going to, I'm just going to come along, and again, you can even mark it. I marked it with my fingernail, right? I'm just going to come along just to match up those quilting lines there. So if you understand what we're doing, I'm just padding that piece, as it were, having laid that piece of batting in there. We're not going to be, you're not going to see this, and that's just going to protect your hand, you know, the back of your hand. But this is where you're holding your pots and pans, this 5 or 6 layer here. That's just to sort of have a bit of a more grip. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to my sewing machine, having just slotted that piece of batting. I hope this makes sense. And then I'm going to just quilt along these lines, just finishing it at that point there. And I'll be back. I've quilted this pocket piece just as I had done the backing piece. And you'll end up with a piece looking like this. I suppose you could interline it. I don't find it's necessary, because it's just the back of your hand here, and you are already have the batting and the piece of fabric. It's more just for control. So I've done it that way, and I've actually stitched it down, quilted it down, and then I've actually just done, for decorative purposes, I've done 1-2 lines of top stitching along the bottom of my handle, bottom of my pocket. So now we're ready just to put it together. And what we're going to do is I'm just going to line that up with that. Just, it doesn't really make a difference, but I quite like that. So that's pretty much the same size, and then we're going to, so we're putting the wrong sides together, and then we're going to be putting our pocket on the top of that. And then what we want to do is we want to go over to our machine, and very close to the edge, we're going to stitch these pieces all together. Maybe you want to do it from the top. Probably you want to do it from the backing. You just want to stitch them all together. That's just to hold them, to hold those pieces together. Maybe even with a little tiny zigzag stitch. I'm not sure. I'll probably just do it on just a little straight stitch. But you want to just do all these together so your pocket, your backing, and your front is secured. I've stitched the edges of my pie together here, securing my pocket. I didn't catch it all. It's a little bit, I didn't catch there, but it's okay. It's fine. Because I'm going to be binding this, and I'm going to catch the whole thing. This is just to secure it. They could actually have just pinned that, really. But what we want to do now is we want to make the little hanging tab. What I've done is I've taken a piece of my bias fold tape, and again, I'm going to do this on the short side. The wide side is down, and then on the top, I've just top stitched along that short side to catch it, to make this hanging tab. I made this about 7 inches or so. What we're going to do is, after I've just secured that together to make the tab, I'm folding it in half, and at the top of my pot holder here, on this binding here, we're going to put this at the top edge here. I'm just going to stitch that along at the very top, just securing that. Now, you would think you would want to do it on the back, but I find that my other one, I want to show you, I put it on the top, and then I've started my rickrack at the top here, and because it's a whole bunch of rickrack, their stuff, I can just sort of then loop up my hanging tab. However, having attached the rickrack here, I can just go up and loop it up, and then cover all that rickrack up, and then just top stitch that along, and sort of make a feature of the hanging tab. That's how I did it. Maybe you could put it on the back. Might that make a bit more sense? But this is how I did it. So I'm just going to come along on that tape there at the top, because it's centered, and I'm just gonna stitch that right along. What do? Reinforce, reinforce, reinforce. My tabs, my hanging tabs will never ever come out. That's just catching that along there. And now I'm going to be showing you how to do the actual tape around the edges. So after stitching my tab down, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be putting the binding around the edge. I had about 20 or 25 inches left of my binding from my other package, but I did open a new package because I want to make sure I have it all the way around. If you want to measure the circumference, I don't know, of this area and see if you have enough, maybe one package will do. I just opened my next package here. Again, very important, what we're going to be doing is we are going to be sewing this as you have the right and or the wider and the shorter side. We're going to be taking our binding. I'm going to be starting, I'm right-handed, hopefully, I don't know, left hands will do, but I'm going to start, I'm going to put just the raw edge of my binding. The wide side, if you can see this, is going to go, I'm going to tuck all this edging right along in there. The wide side of the binding is on that side. So when I sew the narrow edge, it's just a hair, I'll be sure to catch that binding on the backing. So you just want to tuck your edge of your pie right up into that binding edge, right up into that fold, and start stitching. And as you can see with the bias binding, look how neatly that just wraps right around the edge of your pie to make that lovely piece. And when you stitch it, I'll just try to show you. I'll just come here. You're going to stitch it right along the edge, having tucked that. You want to do just bites at a time. Bites. Ha ha, pie. You get it? You just want to do about an inch or so, inch and a half at a time. It's through a lot of material, but not as, it's not like through eight lots of material. It's only just through maybe four or five. You see how I'm doing it? I'm just literally pushing the fold under there, just about an inch and a half. You're not forcing anything. You're just pulling that bias onto the edge. You're putting your, I should say, your pie up into the edge of this binding here, this fold. And it, because it's on the bias, it just tucks around there ever so nicely. You want it nice and firm around there. Go slowly to be able to catch all of these bits. You want to just, look how I'm doing. I'm just sort of like, wah. You just sort of push those, that raw edge. You've already affixed it together. And then we're going to go back, actually, and I'm going to do this again. I'll show you what I'm going to do. I'm just going to go around here, and then I'm just going to show you, to reinforce it again, what I'm going to do. I've come to the end of attaching my binding to the edge of my pie. Oh my word, look, it looks like a pie. Actually, if you didn't want to put the rickrack on, you wouldn't have to. So look, it's caught. Look how beautifully that the underside is caught, the bias binding. However, having said that, because I think there's a whole bunch of material in here, I literally am gonna go back and I'm going to go even closer to that, the backing edge of my binding. So there's just going to be a double stitch. It's not necessary at all, but I just think it looks a lot more professional, and you'll be very, very sure. And maybe on this pocket, I'm just going to go back a bit, because there might be a bit of strain on your pocket when you put your hand in. So it's not necessary, but I like to, you know me, I like to reinforce. So I'm going to go back. You don't have to worry about what the front looks like now, because we're going to be attaching the rickrack. But it just finishes up that binding edge really nice. Back stitch, back stitch, back stitch. Real close. But like, isn't that amazing with the bias tape? You don't have to worry about what's going on underneath it. Because again, the manufacturer has constructed it that way. Oh, I just did raw edge, it's fine. I'm just gonna come here, and that's where our tab is, and that's where everything's gonna sort of end. But we're gonna cover it all up with our tab when we put the rickrack on. So as you can see, I've just done that double edge. When we put the rickrack on, I'll just pull my binding, my tab right up there. But look how professional and how nice. And there's our lovely our lovely pocket there. That's all been caught. Now I'm going to be showing you how we're going to be doing the rickrack. I finished sewing the binding around my pie, and now what we want to do is I'm going to open my pack of rickrack here, and we're going to be doing this double roll, a double layer of rickrack. You don't have to do that. If you just wanted to use, oh, look at that. Nice another piece of card. I just love them. Look at that. What can I do with that? Anyway, if you would want to just take your rickrack, just one even, hopefully you can see, and just with a wavy stitch, attach it along in like, there's your lattice, there's your crimped edge of your pie, right? That's your crimped edge of your pie. I happen to like doing it the double way. And either way, actually, I might just do, for demonstration purposes, I think I'll just stitch that on. I quite like that. Just the one thing. But what I wanted to show you, if you actually wanted to do it doubled, I'll just show you what I do. I'm just going to do it single. What I would do is I would, this is however long it is, it's I'd take two halves of it. So I put the ends of it right out of the package. How long is it? It's 2.5 yards, so a yard and a quarter or so, whatever. Put the two ends with a nice big safety pin. You want to put them together, and on something soft, maybe a piece of fabric. Here, I'm going to do it with my yoga mat here, which is under my machine. You just want to secure it somehow. Okay, so what you want to do is, I'll just cut these in half here. I've just cut the ends in half. What you want to do, literally, if you're wanting to do this double lattice work, the double crimped edge, as it were, what you want to do is, having secured your rickrack, all you want to do is let the rickrack do the job. What you're doing is, you're just literally, if you can see that, you're just literally letting that curved edge, you just separate your tails, and you just let, smoothing it along, wherever it sort of lies, you're not braiding anything, you're lapping, whoops, oh, I just pulled it too tight, you have to be careful, you're just lapping, just keep it nice and loose. Nice and loose. You're lapping one edge over the other, just letting that little, the rickrack, just go into that other one. It's a little bit of a process. You're not braiding. You're just literally lapping, lapping, lapping. One goes here, one goes there, smoothing it the whole time. And then one over the other, one over the other, trying to keep it nice and flat. So there you have this look, if you can see. So what I do is, I'll do the, maybe you can measure with a tape that, and then just do a 2 inches or so more. Secure the end, and then I'll show you what I'm going to be doing. That's the double way to do it. But now I'm just going to be doing one lot of rickrack. So I'll just show you. I'm going to go over to my machine. If you want to do it the double, we're attaching it the exact same way. I'm going to be attaching, I'm starting attaching my single layer of rickrack, just for demonstration purposes. It makes it up really nice, or if you want it a bit thicker of a pie crust, you can. If you can see, I've put my camera this way. If you can see that, I've set my machine on a wavy stitch. a bit close together, but most machines have that type of a wavy stitch. And then coming back to my pot holder, what I've done is I've started up here behind the tab. Remember, we're just going to be hiding all of that stuff behind the tab. What I've done is I've just laid very carefully. I'm not pulling anything. I'm just laying my rickrack along the edge, having just these little waves a little bit outside of the binding, and then very carefully with my wavy stitch, again, just bite by bite, just a few bits, an inch at a time or so, I will be securing the rickrack to the binding edge of my pot holder here. I'm just laying that along there. At points you can see the stitching. That's okay. That's the edge of the pie, as it were. By all means, if you want to do the double rickrack, you can. This is a single rickrack. I've done this many times and it's just as effective. But this pie, you can say I ran out of dough. I ran out of pie crust. And I'm just doing a simple crimped edge on my pie. So again, I'm just going to come along and I'm just going to stitch that pie right along there. And there's my crimped edge of my pie. So I'll just finish that. I've come along to the edge of my crimped edge here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my rickrack and sort of right in the middle, right there, I'm just going to cut it off. And I have two raw edges. That's fine, because that's going to be behind the tab of my pot holder. So I'm just going to go up there. It's very, very heavy, very, very thick. So I'll just go this way. Just secure that down, and then pull my presser foot up. And now all I'm going to do to finish my pot holder is, these are raw edges, I'm just going to pull my tab up, and then very carefully at the top edge there, align these together. Hopefully you can see this. My hand's not in the way. At the very top edge, I have to change my stitch back. Where's my stitch? Where is it? To one. Oh yeah, to one. There in the middle. So I'm just gonna top stitch that. That's gonna go right to the, yeah, top stitch that right there. Back and forth, just secure it. And then all of your raw binding edges, your raw zigzag edges, excuse me, are tucked behind that tab. That's the reason I do it that way. And then we have, oh, pardon me, I have something in my throat. Oh, pardon me. Then we have a finished pot holder. So what do you think? We're done making our pie. Isn't that lovely? I like the single, I like the double crimped edge, if you like, but there you go. So I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. You have a nice mitt. It's lined. This is thick if you're actually going to use them, but they're so pretty. They're so pretty. You might want to just hang them up or put them under your holiday pies. It's real sweet, or just a nice bright touch on the table. I like the way they sort of sit up, and that's the reason why, is because we didn't pad the edges here. So they almost sit up like a little pie. Very real looking. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, folks. I had fun making these. Okay, thanks. Bye.